Okay, hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty and our cast number 95, pretty sure. How's everybody doing? And once again, I'm sorry I kind of screwed up and didn't get my videos, up on time this week. I had like kind of the identical week as the week before, where I got my Monday and Tuesday video up, and then I just didn't get the mental ones up, and then I got Fridays up. And I don't know. This one ain't gonna go up on time either. It's probably gonna go up at midnight or something. But part of that's because I'm having troubles with my computer crashing again, so I'm like backing it up every night, trying to keep my files safe. And I don't know. I mean, I just wonder like how long before it's gonna go off and not start it again. But hopefully it'll keep going. But I don't know. I think the reality is it's like I'm gonna have to figure out something else. But that doesn't matter so much because that's only part of it. That's, hopefully you can't hear Tanya and Tristan fighting back there, man. He's supposed to be taking a nap, so it's always a struggle with any kid. But yeah, this piece I'm doing, it's a commission, for a guy that, has waited patiently for a long time. And, yeah, I kind of forgot about this one. And then the guy was like, hey, when are you going to do that commission? And I was like, oh my God, I forgot all about you. And I jumped on his commission and did it. And then I suddenly realized when I was like trying to send it to him that I hadn't drawn his commission. I had drawn a different guy's commission. And I had completely forgot about his commission. And so then I had to apologize twice and go like, you know what, I drew your commission, but it wasn't yours. I'm really, really sorry. But anyway, he's been really nice and cool about it. And I don't know. I got this one kind of in a flurry of commissions a while ago. And for some reason, it just didn't happen when it was supposed to. It's not really from a movie or anything. It's gonna be a DVD cover, I think, or a CD cover, like for a short movie. So, and it's not gonna be a painting; it's just gonna be a drawing, and I think that's really cool. So, yeah, I don't know. I mean, since this is like episode number 95, I thought I maybe should talk a little bit about just like what is going on, why I'm missing videos and stuff. And I think I kind of brought it up in one of the Artcasters chats or something, but I don't think anybody really kind of knew what the heck I was talking about at the time. But I was kind of talking about just, you know, like when you do videos or do whatever, you start to realize like people are listening and watching you and stuff, and you know, and you get this kind of feeling of like, well, almost like camera shyness or something, or like second guessing what you're doing. Not so much with the art, but just with the, especially with like the videos and like talking and stuff. Because last week, and also this week, I actually had videos for the days I missed, and I didn't upload them, and they're still sitting on my computer. And just like the one, you know, yesterday's video I missed, and I have that one done, and I didn't upload it. Because I kind of second guessed myself. I guess I'm not even drawing on screen here. Oh, wait a minute. Forgot. I'm just going to cut this audio in, because I shot a bunch of footage for this piece, so I just thought I'd almost do a little bit of a speed paint for the part that I'm doing here. But like what I was saying is, I felt, you know, and it shouldn't be that way, but it's just, for some reason it is. It's been kind of happening to me, and I haven't, not quite sure what to do about it, and I'm not sure I want to really do anything about it also. Because I think that, you know, there's like, well, I mean, I guess what I'm saying is, it's like, you know, when I first started these videos, I think I started them, I mean, for one thing, I had something to talk about, and I didn't really have anybody to talk to about it that was going to agree with me, you know what I mean? I could have found somebody to talk to me, but nobody in their right mind would have said, hey, Jeff, you know, go out on your own and do this thing. Nobody that I would, you know, gave a shit about listening to, you know. And so that was part of the motivation, was to just, you know, talk to myself in a way. I didn't really, I think, realize that there was so many people listening. Not that I have that huge of an audience, but there was a fair amount of people that reacted to those first few videos when I left my job, and I think that kind of helped me kind of have the nerve to do it, I guess, to leave, quit. And then I think I also thought, if I kept going with them, it would be a good way to sort of make sure I was drawing every day, get myself, you know, my butt in the chair, so to speak. Because I think I also worried about that, was, you know, that I would quit and then I would sort of do the flaky artist thing and not get my work done. Which didn't really happen. And hasn't happened. What has happened is, it's like, after you draw for a while every day, it just becomes your work, you know? You just get up and you go to work every day, and you get out a piece of paper and you draw. And the whole basis for my business, that, you know, I sort of bet my income on, or whatever, when I left my job, was to basically just, if I could basically just draw a piece every day and sell it. And that was pretty much it, you know, and not necessarily do one every day, but basically just create art and sell it was my deal. And it worked, and you know, it's cool because I've seen it now inspire other people, and that really is kind of just what it is, you know. It's like, you know, I mean, paint something that somebody's going to want and then sell it to them. It's kind of as simple as that. But, you know, in doing that, I don't know. So there's like two reasons I was doing the videos. Now it's sort of like, I think I've got, you know, and I've done like 95 of them now. And I really find myself sort of looking for a reason why I keep doing these videos. Which, you know, I'll always keep doing videos just because I like doing them. But I really, you know, I feel like I've kind of said what I had to say in a way. You know what I mean? And not that I don't have more to say, I guess, but I don't know. I think I'm not sure what I'm going to do when I hit like 100 videos. I might actually stop. Just for that fact. It's not like, you know, I'm not getting work done because I'm making too many videos or something. I mean, I draw during all these videos, so it's like work gets done, you know. Trying to get the camera. I guess it doesn't really matter so much that I don't have anything to say, because, like, anytime I say anything like that, people, you know, say things like they just like drawing with me every day, and that sort of thing, and I agree with that. I understand that a ton. I really like to have a good podcast to listen to while I draw, you know. It's one of the things that, you know, I like, and it drives me crazy when I can't find one. But by the same token, it's sort of like, I don't know, sometimes I just feel like I got nothing to talk about. And, not so much that, actually. Because I don't know that I ever really start the camera and think that I have something to talk about. More like I just feel like sometimes I'm repeating myself, I think, you know. Like, I think, like, I almost started these podcasts trying to say, like, kind of what I just said a little while ago, which was basically, like, you could do it. Whether I was trying to talk myself into it or, you know, just let people know that it's possible. I mean, it was, like, twofold, you know. I wanted to do what, like, you know, Mike Hoffman did for me, which was basically say, hey, stupid, you know, you can sell. This is like, this isn't the internet. This is a gigantic store. And there's people there that are buying stuff, you know. But, you know, just that, and then also just, like I said, you know, like, it's possible to just draw and paint, and you don't have to have a job, you know. Yeah, just draw something every day and sell it. That's like what it is. And I feel like now that I've kind of said that, and then, you know, I've talked about all the other stuff, like all the what works, and here's set up a store this way, or get on eBay, or find a market somewhere, or, you know, I mean, all that kind of stuff, you know, it just seems like I've covered it. And anyway, I think you guys are getting the gist of what I'm saying. So I don't know what I'm going to do, really. One thing I am going to do, though, is, it's October. I should talk to my patrons from Patreon, which I haven't talked about lately. But I am going to be changing around my Patreon campaign. I think that it's just way too confusing, and I don't really want to send prints out anymore as like a incentive, because it's too confusing trying to keep track of what people want and if they paid for a print or if they didn't and all that good stuff. So what I'm going to do is just, I'm going to change the whole thing to like a monthly charge instead of, like, you know, the weekly thing, which that's the way the Patreon site charges anyway. It just charges everybody at the end of the month, so then it's like, you know, if you're there at the end of the month, you get charged, and if you're not, then you don't, you know, and it's no big deal. It's not like I accidentally send out prints to somebody because I thought they were there, and then they were gone, you know, when the charge happened. I'm not really complaining about any of it. I'm just trying to make it, like, simple. Because it's confusing to me, and it's also confusing to, like, the people that want to pledge. So, anyway, I'm just going to make it, like, one $5 a month pledge that you can either, you know, that you can do or not. There's no, you know, no requirement. And, you know, I was going to give away discounts on the prints. So, you know, those people who want prints all the time, I'll give away a discount code that you can only get if you're on there. And then also, I'm going to keep the drawing, you know, the end of the month drawing giveaway, which I think is really why most people are on there anyway. So, that's all going to happen. pretty soon. So I don't know. I imagine I'm probably going to lose most of my patrons when that happens. But I really think it's worth it to do it now before this thing gets bigger and gets more out of hand, you know? I think too, it's like, you know, if you guys are setting up one yourself or something, honestly, like, I think simplicity is the way to go, because I did it a little bit more complicated, I think, than I should have. Especially with, like, giving away prints and stuff, physical items. And, you know, I think the Patreon just isn't there in a way. Like, maybe Kickstarter, or maybe even Kickstarter isn't quite there, too. To basically just get you your money, you know what I mean? Because, you know, you need the money to send out prints and, you know, all that kind of stuff, and buy paper and ink and, and, you know, like, in the beginning, Patreon was like, really squirrely and wasn't, like, charging. Which I know I've been on there for a few months, so, and they're not that old of a site, but, you know, there was, like, a couple months at the beginning I didn't even get money for, like, the donations. And that didn't even get sorted out till, like, a few months ago. And then, there's just a lot of stuff, you know, with, like, the limiting, you know. People can pledge one thing, and then they can put a limit on their pledge. You know, they can pledge $5 and put a $1 limit on their pledge in a different part of the site, which is like, wow, that's super confusing. And that was another thing I completely missed, you know, in the beginning with a few people who got prints, you know. So it's like, those prints, they didn't get, even get paid for. And, you know, there's no place to charge shipping. And, you know, I have, like, quite a few people that are out of the country. So that makes it, you know, harder. And then, you know, it's not like there's an order form, you know. I, like, message people, it's like, what prints do you want, and they don't get back to you and stuff. I'm not complaining. I appreciate everybody who pledged on there and stuff, but, you know, it's like, it's nice to go through a couple months of that, because then it makes you really realize, like, what works and what doesn't. And, you know, like the drawing raffle and stuff, everybody loves that. It's fun to do. Everybody gets into it. Most people jump on that. Basically, it's like a $4 a month pledge, just so they can get in that raffle. And none of those guys ever have a problem with anything. And you know, also, it's like, for, like, the drawing raffle, it's, I don't know, you know, somebody's card bounces or something like that, it's not a big deal, because I'm not having to, like, out of, you know, take money out of my pocket to send them something. And cards bounce, you know what I mean? I can really see, like, you know, you hear all the horror stories with, like, Kickstarter and stuff, and I know that, like, on Kickstarter, that happens too, is a lot of times people will, you know, let their cards bounce and stuff. And then I've even heard other people, like, say that, like, people would pledge just to kind of, like, help it succeed, and then, like, jump out. Jump out when it was time to pay, which is, like, that even, you know. Because there you're paying for, like, a project. If you need, like, you know, $2,000 to do a book, and you only get, like, $1,000, it's like, well, how do you do your book then, you know? But then everybody who pledged damn sure is going to expect it, you know. So I don't know. I don't know about all this crowdfunding stuff. But I do know I'm going to change my Patreon. I think it's going to work a ton better. And I'm also trying to think about other stuff that I can give. Because I don't pay that much attention to what's going on there. But, you know, maybe I can figure out videos or something like that. I don't know. And I also think, you know, it's like, I listened to this one guy, Jack Spirko. He does this podcast called The Survival Podcast. He makes his living podcasting, basically. And Actually, he's a great person to bring up, too, on another point. But anyway, he's got, like, a membership thing to his site. But it's not like you got to join it. It's like, if you don't want to join it, you know, I haven't joined it. You know, you get everything for free, basically. He just puts it on there for people who want to support him. And then, you know, when they support him, he's got a thing where you get discounts to different stuff, you know. It's like a survival podcast, so it's, you know, a bunch of preppers and stuff like that. So he's got, like, you know, discounts to, like, I don't know, co-ops and stuff, you know what I mean? I don't know, it doesn't matter. The point is just, you know, people, you know, get on there because they want to just support what he does. And I was looking at his, and his is basically $5 a month. And that's it. And it's not on Patreon or anything like that, but that's like the option. You go on there, you want to support the show, it's like $5 a month. And I just think it's like a great model in a way, because it just takes away the confusion, and it also takes away sort of like that, you know, it takes away the higher tiers, so if somebody wants to give you a bunch of money. But, you know, I felt like actually kind of bad about like some of the guys who were giving me like quite a bit of money on there. If they were just buying stuff, it'd have been different. Yeah, it's this weird sort of thing on there. I mean, because it's like, I felt bad in a way, but then it's like the people who were like, you know, jumping on and jumping back off and letting the cards bounce and all that kind of stuff, then I felt, you know, sort of like ripped off by those people because they weren't, you know, getting charged like everybody, you know, I don't know. But anyway, I just think it's like a good way, you know. People, it just fits the business model. Anyway, that's what I'm going to do. The thing about that Jack Spirko, though, why I thought, you know, he is kind of a good topic, is because, you know, and I know you guys don't know who I'm talking about, but, or at least I don't think so, but he, you know, he's been doing, like, a podcast for, like, 5 or 6 years, and it's grown into this monster thing. And, I mean, he's basically kind of got this cult of a personality, you know what I mean? I mean, these guys, people follow him like they follow, like, a radio talk show host or something. And, you know, he's the kind of guy who fits that, you know what I mean? I mean, he can, like, he's the kind of guy who's going to get people to follow him, you know what I mean? And, you know, it's, I mean, what am I going to say? I don't want to make it sound bad, but it's almost like Jim Jones or something, you know? He's got that kind of personality, or that's a horrible thing to say, but those kind of people, they have, like, that kind of personality where people want to, you know, they want to follow him or get it, you know what I mean? It's like they see him as a leader and they get on board, you know? And I just don't have that kind of personality, you know? It's just not what I want in a way. And I feel sort of uncomfortable when people sort of look to me for, like, I don't know. This is kind of almost like what I'm talking about here sometimes. It's just like I just get to the point where I'm like, what am I saying? I don't even know. And I kind of don't even care, you know. But anyway, I'm going to go ahead and wrap the show up. I hope that I can edit that into like something that makes sense. And I'll see you guys Monday for the ArtCast. ArtCasters Chat or whatever. See you guys.